Hi, this is Pratiksha Jain, and in this video, I am going to explain code related to water jug problem. But before that, I would like to explain that why it is called as water jug problem. So suppose we have a jug of 4 liters and another jug of 3 liters, and we want to measure it out 2 liters. Now you might be thinking that it is very easy because every jug might be having marking of 1 liter, 2 liter, 3 liter and so on. But here the problem is that jugs do not have marking. So now if they don't have marking, then how we will measure 2 liters out of it? So let us go towards the code. So the first line of the code says that we'll be asking the user to input the value of jug 1, then jug 2, and then the goal, that is the amount of water to be measured. Suppose the user has entered 4 and 3 as jug 2, and the goal of amount is 2 liters. So now, I will explain these functions later. Before explaining these functions, we will go to the end of the code. Let's consider two variables, that is x and y, and the value of these two variables will be initially 0. That means both the jugs have initial 0 values. But as we know that we have taken two values of jug from the user, so later those two values of the jugs will be used for the code. Okay, so but for the code, basically x and y are 0, but in real time jug 1 and jug 2 has value that has been taken from the user itself. So for the future use, the user might use those values of jug 1 and jug 2 to assign to x and y. So basically x is jug 1, which is initialized to 0, and basically y is jug 2, that has been initialized to 0 by default. So now we say that while it is true, and if x, that is my jug 1, is equal to goal. So we have taken goal measure as 2 from the user. So my value of jug 1 or the value of jug 2, any of these value, any of the jug tends to have the goal, then we will say that goal is achieved and we will break over there and we will stop the loop. That means we will come out of the loop. But if this is not true, then we will go in the else part and we will go to the display function first, and then we will have a choice. So we will ask the user to input its true. User will be mentioning its choice, and those values will be further given to apply rule function, and then the status will be printed saying the current state and x and y value, that is jug 1 and jug 2 value. So now let us run this code, and with the help of this code I will explain you the functions above. Let us see the result. Okay, so it is asking me to enter the value of jug 1. So suppose it is 4. We have entered the capacity of jug is 4, jug 1 as 4. Now jug 2 as suppose 3, and the amount of water to be measured is suppose 2. That means out of jug 4 and jug 3, I want only 2 as my measure of water. Okay, so the user has entered all the details. Now select the rule to be applied. That means there are total 8 rules that the user has called, and out of these 8 rules, the user can apply any rule that he or she wants. Now, these 8 rules are being displayed with the help of display function. And here is that display function. The display function has the values, has the print function, has the print statements in it, which are displaying all the 8 rules. Now, these 8 rules again have a path to another function. That means that is the apply rule function. We will talk about that also. Now, this green marking shows that we are at this path right now. So, it is asking to apply the rule. Now, for initial state, my x and y value are at 0, right? So, we need to fill the jugs first, jug 1 and jug 2. Now, you might be saying that jug 2 and jug 1 are already been filled by the user. Yeah, they are being filled. But initially, for the code, we have taken x and y as 0. That means we are leaving again it on user that whether you want to actually fill your jug with 4 value, or you want to fill it your jug 2 with 3 value, or you don't want to fill it and keep them empty if you don't want to do anything. So suppose if I want to fill my jug 1 and jug 2 both, so I will give apply the rule 1 to fill the jug 1. So the current status changes to 4 and then 0. This was rule 1. So let's go and see what the rule 1 says. Is the rule 1 says that if my jug 1 is empty, or if it is less than the capacity. So we have given the capacity of jug 1 as 4, right? So of course the jug 1 was empty at starting. So if the jug 1, that is my x, is less than j1. Now initially we had kept x as 0 and jug 1 is 4, right? So of course my x is less than j1. So replace the value of x, that is 0, with the value of j1, that is 4, and return y as it is, because we haven't added anything into y yet. So the y will return 0. Now if we will choose second rule, then what will second rule check is that whether the jug 2 is empty. Then yes, yeah, jug 2 is empty. It is basically at 0, right? Y is 0. So my jug 2 capacity is 3, right? So my y will tend to j2 value. this was a condition where jug was empty. But suppose if my jug 2 was not empty, and if I have gone for this condition, then if my jug 2 capacity is 3, right? And if the jug capacity is already being filled. So again, if I try to apply this rule, it will give me an error saying that rule cannot be applied. So let's go and apply rule 2 also. So here it is 4 and 0 right now. And after applying rule 2, it will become 4 and 3. Let's apply rule 2. It is 4 and 3 now. Now, if I want to empty any of the jug, right? So suppose let's empty jug 1 because I want to transfer my jug 2 value into jug 1. So for that, I need to empty my jug 1 because my jug 1 is already to its capacity, that is 4. So I need to empty my jug 1. So let's go for rule 3 and just let's empty the jug 1. This is rule 3 and let's empty the jug 1. Yes, the jug 1 is the jug 1 got empty, and let's transfer all the water from jug 2 to jug 1 so that my jug 2 also comes empty. Go for rule 6. Okay, so yeah, jug 2 was having the value as 3. After applying rule 6, that is transfer all water from jug 2 to jug 1. Now my jug 1 is having 3 and the jug 2 is having value as 0. So let's check out rule 3 and let's check out rule 6 and 5 because 6 and 5 are doing almost same thing. So let's go to, before going to 5 and 6, let's look after empty jug 1. So if the jug 1, that is my x value, is greater than 0, then just replace the value of x with 0 and return it. And if the rule cannot be applied, return the statement as rule cannot be applied and return x and y current value. The same goes for rule 4 for emptying the jug 2. Now let's go for transfer all water from jug 1 to jug 2. Now suppose if my jug 1 value is greater than 0, of course, if my jug 1 is not empty, then only I can transfer the water from jug 1 to jug 2, right? So I need to check the condition first that whether my jug 1 is greater than 0, yes. If it is not, then it will state that rule cannot be applied. But if it is greater than 0, if x plus y, that is my jug 1 and jug 2 value, is less than or equal to j2 value, that is my jug 2 value, then only my j1 value, that is my x, will get empty and it will transfer all its water to x plus y, that is my j2. Say next, if x plus y, that is my jug 1 and jug 2 value, is less than or equal to j2 value, that is my jug 2 value, then only my j1 value, that is my x, will get empty and it will transfer all its water to x plus y, that is my j2. Same rule gets applied here. Here we are checking for a jug 1, whether it is empty or not, and here we are checking for jug 1, that is jug 2. Let's go to rule 7 and rule 8. Now we have transferred all our water from jug 2 to jug 1. Now let us fill jug 2 again. Let's go for rule number 2, sorry, not 4. Okay, so the current state says that jug 1 and jug 2 are full. So now what we will do is, we know that jug 1 capacity is 4 and jug 2 capacity is 3. Now what we will do, we will fill jug 1 to its full capacity, and we will and what will happen is, when we will transfer some water from jug 2 to jug 1, then jug 1 will return 4 and jug 2 will return 2 liters. So here we achieve our goal because we had mentioned that the goal we want to achieve is, that the goal we want to achieve is 2. So let's go down and apply, transfer some water from jug 2 to jug 1 until jug 1 is full. So let's apply rule 8. Here is a green mark that says that the code is ended. Yeah, the current state has been achieved. We have achieved 2 liters. So the goal is achieved. Thank you for watching the video.